Hey, what's going on, guys? I wanted to address something really quick. I wanted to explain to you another model that we actually have for understanding wealth and where money comes from. And it's called the R&D model. The R&D model for income generation. The R&D model that you can use to create streams of revenue, secondary income, things like that. And basically, the R&D stands for relationships and delegation. Relationships and delegation. The reason that I put together that particular model is because one of the things that I've noticed is that a lot of Black entrepreneurs, one of the reasons that they struggle is because they tend to sort of do everything on their own. We tend to believe that it's this sort of, that entrepreneurship is sort of this one man, one woman hustle, that you pretty much have to just do it all by yourself, and you have to sort of, you know, make it all happen on your own, and whatever you don't know how to do, you have to learn how to do it, and all this other stuff. Now, let me just tell you, this is not true. I once heard a billionaire basically explain that, you know, when he thought about what it took to become a billionaire, he said, it's not about what you do. It's about what you get other people to do. And that made me think about the two parts of the R&D. R&D stands for relationships and delegation. So let's talk about the relationship aspect. One of the challenges that I think Black people have, particularly in America, but this is kind of an issue around the world. Anywhere there's been colonialism and white supremacy, Black people have been historically divided. Anywhere you go, you'll see examples of Black people divided in ways that are unimaginable, that are kind of crazy. And with this division, you see the breakdown of relationships. You see the breakdown of families. You see business projects that can't get done because the people working on the project can't get along. You see people that are, you know, sort of don't trust anybody, so they sort of try to do everything on their own, and the business fails, or the business dies once the person dies. You know, you get sick, the business can't function because the business is tethered to a living being. You see, now here's the thing: to make money on a high level, you have to have your business get to a point where it is not tethered to your humanity, or tethered to the length of your life, or tethered to how long or how healthy you are. The business should be almost like a machine. A machine can operate without a human being. A machine can operate, a machine doesn't get tired. A machine is able to function long after you're gone, etc. And so part of the first step toward building that machine is nurturing relationships. And there are a couple types of relationships that matter that I've seen. One is relationships in terms of family. If you have children, your children can be part of your labor force and your legacy. Your children, if you train them properly, can help you sustain and maintain the family business. For example, I have a son. He's not my biological son, but I love him just like he was. And basically, you know, he does things I don't want to do. He was working when I'm not working. He knows how to do things I can't do. If there's a skill that we need to bring into the company, I'll go send him to a training program, and so that I don't have to do it. And it's not just my family members. My brother also works with me as well. So I've got family involved. But then even beyond that, there are other relationships that you might form with potential business partners who can either come in and work for you, or people that can work with you, right? So knowing the difference between who should work for you and who should work with you, that's kind of that's a subtlety that we kind of touch on in blackmoney103.com, which is our entrepreneurship program, blackmoney103.com. But in general, the formation of relationships is actually one of the most important aspects of making money. People will not do business with you. People will not help you make money if they don't trust you and if they don't know you. That's just a fact. I've seen situations where I brought the best idea, the best proposal, the best price to the table and didn't even get the time of day. But then I've seen other situations where I knew somebody and had a personal relationship with them, and all the things that used to be hard suddenly became easy. All the doors that would not open suddenly flew open. Byron Allen actually talks about, he's worth about $400 million. And he actually talks about how he could not get people to return his calls when he was first doing business. And then he formed a relationship with a guy who had carried some weight. And so Byron got invited to a party by this guy. And the guy brought Byron in and he said, stop the music. Everybody in here, this is Byron Allen. If he calls you to do business with you, make sure you pick up that phone. And then all of a sudden, boom, things became very easy for him. So you want to spend time nurturing relationships. This is something I had to grow into. The nurturing of relationships, I would argue, is probably one of the most important parts of doing business. Books by guys like George Frazier and others teach you how to network properly. The nurturing of relationships, I cannot overstate the importance of forming new relationships, but also protecting old ones. That means if you have business partners, there are ways to resolve disputes where you can agree in advance to be on a specific code of conduct. For example, contractually, we're going to all make sure that we settle everything in arbitration so we're not sitting in court spending a bunch of money with lawyers. Or if we have a dispute, we are forced to sit down and resolve it. Or we make a personal agreement that we're going to talk to each other so that we don't have misunderstandings, things like that. So the protection of relationships and the building of new relationships is one of the most important parts of business. Delegation comes down to realizing that you just don't want to try to do it all by yourself. You know, learning leadership skills and delegation and the maintenance of a system is one of the most important things a young person can learn. Because think about this. When you're Black, you're kind of raised to be a laborer. Everything that you're taught is you get up and you go to work for somebody every day, and you're going to work yourself into the ground. And if you want more money, you just work more hours. Well, that's not a good way to work, because when you're working and you're doing all the labor, then you can only do 40, 50, 60, 70, maybe 80 hours, 100 hours a week. But if you have 10 people and they're all doing 40 hours a week, well, then you're doing 400 hours a week of labor, which is far more than any one human being can do. So the ability to delegate, which involves training people to the point where you can trust them to delegate to them properly, and then knowing how to supervise people, actually becomes more important than how much work you do by yourself. So don't get caught up in this myth that, you know, being successful as an entrepreneur is about how hard you work. That is important. That's a very important part of it. And the hard work never really goes away. Even to this day, I work very hard. But a lot of the time I spend working is spent delegating. It's having meetings with people, communicating with people, talking about what I want, getting experts on board who can help us do the things that we're trying to do. I don't spend so much of the time doing the task myself as much time as I spend maintaining relationships and delegating to people who can get the work done on behalf of our company. Okay, so at the end of the day, if you want to scale up, You have to apply the R&D model. This is something we put together in the Black Business School. You're not going to read, I mean, the other place you read R&D is going to stand for research and development. For us, R&D stands for relationships and delegation. And that's one of the specific unique models we put together in the Black Business School. Because once again, I reiterate to you, our number one challenge, our number one problem we're solving is the Black wealth equation. We're not solving any other equation for anybody else. So we're uniquely focusing on the Black community and where our limitations are so that we can make ourselves better. So you can move on to the next lecture. And also, don't forget, you have bonus materials within your course that will allow you to have everything you need in order to move forward, no matter what country you live in. So take care, guys. See you soon.